The highly anticipated race to the moon between two billionaire-led space companies Blue Origin and SpaceX is gaining momentum. On Friday, May 19th, NASA awarded a contract to Blue Origin, led by Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, to construct a lunar landing craft for transporting astronauts to and from the moon's surface. Now, why did NASA decide to award such contract to Blue Origin, since SpaceX is already developing a human landing system for Artemis generation with the use of Starship? Bill Nelson, the NASA administrator, highlighted the agency's intention to foster healthy competition and ensure reliability and backup options by partnering with both companies. So, what exactly does this mean for SpaceX, and what does Blue Origin have hidden up its sleeve? Please hit the subscribe button to help the channel out, and let's get into the topic. This is Adventures in Space. $3.4 billion contract was awarded to Blue Origin by NASA, and they soon tweeted, "We selected Blue Origin to develop the human landing system for the Artemis 5 mission. This component for deep space transportation will help us in our goal of sending astronauts to the surface of the moon and returning them home safely." In terms of implications, Blue Origin will be responsible for the design, development, testing, and validation of its Blue Moon lander to fulfill NASA's requirements for a human landing system. This will facilitate recurring astronaut expeditions to the lunar surface, including the critical task of docking with Gateway, a space station used for crew transfers in lunar orbit. Alongside the design and development work, the contract encompasses an unmanned demonstration mission to the moon's surface, followed by a crewed demonstration during the Artemis 5 mission in 2029. As for the reasoning behind NASA's decision to include a second company alongside SpaceX, the agency stated that it aims to promote competition, reduce costs for taxpayers, establish a regular frequency of lunar landings, invest further in the lunar economy, and facilitate preparations for future Mars missions. Lisa Watson Morgan, the manager of the Human Landing System program, emphasized that having two distinct lunar lander designs with different approaches enhances robustness, encourages innovation, reduces expenses, and fosters commercial capabilities for serving other customers and nurturing a lunar economy. Earlier, NASA had already contracted SpaceX to demonstrate an initial human landing system for the Artemis 3 mission. Under that agreement, SpaceX was also directed to refine its design to align with NASA's sustainability requirements and demonstrate the lander during Artemis 4. With the addition of the contract awarded to Blue Origin, which involves demonstrating a lander meeting the same sustainability criteria on Artemis 5, including increased crew capacity, longer mission duration, and greater payload delivery to the moon, multiple providers will compete for future opportunities to fulfill NASA's lunar surface access needs for Artemis missions. Considering the timeline, Blue Origin and its team have a substantial amount of time to prepare, with a primary mission scheduled 6 years from now for 2029. However, as mentioned earlier, they are expected to conduct a demonstration mission prior to the actual Artemis landing. Blue Origin essentially made a huge comeback in this modern space race by winning this contract. After unsuccessful attempts to gain NASA's approval and funding, being sued, and a ton of criticism from the public, this contract now encompasses not only Blue Origin, but also their esteemed national team, consisting of partners such as Lockheed Martin, Draper, Boeing, Astrobotic, and Honeybee Robotics. Together, Blue Origin and its national team collaborators will undertake the development and launch of a lunar landing capable of achieving precision landings on any location across the moon's surface. Additionally, they will work on a cislunar transporter. Both the lunar lander and the cislunar transporter will be powered by LOX-LH2, a combination of liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen. The team highlights that the high specific impulse of LOX-LH2 offers a remarkable advantage for demanding deep space missions requiring substantial energy. However, previous missions have favored lower performance propellants, such as hydrazine and nitrogen tetroxide, which are more easily storable. This preference arises from the challenge of LOX-LH2 boil-off during the extended duration of these missions. In a company statement, Blue Origin said, "Through this contract, we will move the state of the art forward by making high-performance LOX-LH2 a storable propellant combination. under SLD, we will develop and fly solar-powered 20-degree Kelvin cryocoolers and the other technologies required to prevent LOX-LH2 boil-off, future missions beyond the Moon, and enabling capabilities such as high-performance nuclear thermal propulsion will benefit greatly from storable LH2. Blue Origin's architecture also prepares for that future day when lunar ice can be used to manufacture LOX and LH2 propellants on the Moon, they said. Blue Origin's main offering will be the Blue Moon, a lunar lander that comes in a cargo lander version. This variant is specifically designed to ensure dependable, consistent, and economical transportation of diverse payloads to the surface of the Moon. Depending on the specific setup and objective, Blue Origin aims to successfully land multiple metric tons of payload on the Moon, including items like sizable rovers, habitats, and ascent stages. The purpose of this service is to enable increased possibilities for scientific research, on-site resource utilization, the establishment of infrastructure, and logistical missions. These opportunities are intended for government entities, academic institutions, and commercial customers alike. The planned capacity of the lander is to deliver approximately 10,000 pounds of payload to the Moon's surface. Additionally, the cargo vehicle has the potential to support NASA's activities in the area between Earth and the Moon, and transport payloads of ice from Shackleton Crater to aid space operations. Blue Origin initiated the development of the lander in 2016, publicly announced the project in 2017, and revealed a model of Blue Moon lander in May of 2019. According to the information available as of 2018, the first intended mission for the spacecraft was a landing in the lunar South Pole region by 2024. The proposal suggested a series of landings to deliver the necessary infrastructure and establishing a moon base. In conclusion, the battle of the billionaires in space has taken an exciting turn, with both Blue Origin and SpaceX securing contracts from NASA to develop lunar landers. This competition is expected to enhance reliability and backup options, ultimately benefiting NASA, the American people, and advancing humanity's exploration of space. While SpaceX focuses on returning astronauts to the Moon after more than 5 decades, Blue Origin's vision includes establishing human permanence on the Moon and ensuring consistent access to it. Collaborations with prominent aerospace companies highlight the ambitious goals and potential long-term impacts of these missions. NASA anticipates that these ventures will not only aid in future Mars exploration, but also serves as stepping stones for even more distant journeys into space. Thank you very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel to stay updated everything space race related and more. We do 4 essays every week in relevant topics, and you have 2 more in front of you right now. This was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I hope to see you at the next one.